स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द सिलेबस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, सो फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड वी विल रिवाइज वट एवर वी हैव स्टडीड इन फोर्थ सेमेस्टर. सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट रिविजन क्लास, दैट इज completely about the aldehyde and the ketones, because you know that the major portion in your syllabus is covered by the topic aldehyde and ketones, and the other topics are diazonium salt, nitro compounds, and FTIR spectroscopy. So first of all, in our revision class, we will discuss about the aldehyde and ketones, and then further we will discuss about the remaining units as well. So in aldehyde and ketones, what this chapter will include, the chapter outline is first of all structure of aldehyde and ketones, followed by their nomenclature, how we can nomenclate the aldehyde and ketones, followed by their physical properties, and then finally the chemical properties of aldehyde and ketones. So first of all, the structure of the aldehyde and ketones, as we very much know that aldehyde and ketones both contain the carbonyl group, and this carbonyl group is C double bond O, and oxygen contain two lone pair of electrons. Now aldehyde will be, for example, we have this as a carbonyl group, and these two are the R group, and that will be ketone. And if these two are hydrogen, or one of the R group is hydrogen at that time, it will be aldehyde, otherwise it will be ketone. For example, this one is your ketone, and these two belongs to the aldehyde category. As we know that carbonyl group is also present in case of carboxylic acid, in case of their derivatives that will include the ester, that amide, acid chloride, and anhydride. So that will also contain the functional group C double bond O. So basically aldehyde and ketones are the compound that will contain C double bond O group, and their general formula is CnH2nO. Its general formula is CnH2nO. If I am particularly concerned about the structure of the aldehyde and ketones, you know, this is particularly a ketone, and in this ketone these two are the R groups. They may be same or they may be different, and when we are talking about the bond angle between these two R groups, as it the picture describe, that the angle between these two R groups is 120 degree. Similarly, if we are talking about the bond angle between this R group and this oxygen is also 120 degree, and there is a pi bond formation between the carbon and the oxygen, and oxygen contain lone pair of electron. We have in case of ketone, if I am particularly talking about, for example, this is your C double bond O, which is a carbonyl group. Bond is generally shorter, it is stronger and more polar as comparison to carbon-carbon multiple bond, because we know that in our chapter we will also discuss about the similarities and the dissimilarities between this carbon oxygen double bond and carbon-carbon multiple bond, carbon-carbon double bond specifically. So if I am particularly concerned about the difference, you know, the carbonyl group, specifically the C double bond O, that is a shorter, it will be stronger and more polar as comparison to carbon-carbon multiple bond, because there is a electronegativity difference between carbon and oxygen, and because of that one we can say that this is more polar. If we are particularly concerned about the bond length in carbonyl group C double bond O, it is 1.23 angstrom, and if we are talking about the alkene C double bond C, it is about 1.34 angstrom, and this is the energy, and this is the energy for the C double bond O. So that's all about the structure of the aldehyde and the ketones, in which the bond angle is 120 degree. And if we are particularly talking about the bond length between the carbon and the oxygen, it will be 1.23 angstrom. So it is polar, it is a stronger, and it is a shorter bond as comparison to C double bond C. Now we will discuss about the nomenclature pattern in aldehyde and ketones. When we come to the nomenclature pattern, first of all, because we are particularly concerned about a specific functional group here, and we are only concerned about the aldehyde and ketones, and we must be knowing about the general guidelines regarding the IUPAC nomenclature system of all other functional groups. So we have two type of the nomenclature system. One will be the common name, and another will be the IUPAC nomenclature system. So first of all, we will discuss about the common name. And we are particularly talking about aldehyde now, then aldehyde will be followed by ketones. So in case of aldehydes, if I am particularly talking about common name, generally its name will be derived from the common name of the carboxylic acid. And what we have to do for that? In case of carboxylic acid, we use generally IC acid as a suffix. So we will have to drop that IC acid, this word we will have to drop it here. And in contrast to this one, after dropping this particular word, we will have to add aldehyde. For example, if we are particularly talking about carboxylic acid, that will contain only single carbon. We know that the common name of that carboxylic acid is formic acid. So what we will have to do here, IC acid will be dropped and this aldehyde will be added, so the name will become formaldehyde. So common name should be derived from the carboxylic acid. Similarly, if we are particularly talking about the carboxylic acid in which we have two carbon, at that time the nomenclature will be acetic acid, it will be the common name, in which IC acid has been replaced with aldehyde, so the name will become acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde means for the compound in which we are having two carbon atoms, and the similarly we are having propionic acid, so it will become propionaldehyde, and we are having butyric acid, so now the butyric acid will be butyraldehyde. So this is the common system of nomenclature for aldehydes. Here are a list of some of the acids that you know will explain the different common name of this compound. For example, this is your acid, this is your formic acid, then formaldehyde, then acetaldehyde, propionaldehyde, if we are particularly talking about, this is butyraldehyde, this is veraldehyde, and this is caproaldehyde, which belongs to this particular series, caproic acid. So this is the common system of nomenclature in case of aldehydes, right? If we are particularly talking about the positions, for example, if some different groups are attached, at that time we will have to identify the positions. For example, this is a group in which we are having this C double bond O group at alpha position, then beta, gamma, and then delta position. So different type of groups may occupy different kind of the positions, so the nomenclature will be now accordingly. For example, this is a case, this is, if hydroxyl group is not attached, in that case the nomenclature will be veraldehyde, as this one. So the nomenclature in that case will be veraldehyde. And if we have added hydroxyl group there, at that time we will have to number this particular carbonyl group as alpha position, this will be beta position, this will be gamma position, and this will be, you know, delta position. So accordingly we can have nomenclature in case of common system. So in case of common system, we generally use alpha, beta and gamma to identify the positions of the groups which are attached with the aldehyde or the ketones. In case of IUPAC system, as previously I told you, that there are some general guidelines regarding nomenclature of every functional group, and for that system the first general guideline, the first rule for that one is we will have to select the longest carbon chain, and which will be the longest carbon chain in any kind of molecule that will contain the highest number of carbon atoms in a chain, followed by the functional group. Means it must contain a functional group if it is present inside a molecule, and it should be a highest in number. For example, if in a molecule we are having so many carbon atoms and there are so many branches, so we will select the branch as the longest carbon chain, and that will be your principal system. So first of all, in case of carbonyl system, we will have to identify our longest carbon chain. After longest carbon chain, as we know that for one carbon we generally use methward, and for two carbon we use eth, and similarly for three, prop, but, pent, hex, hept. So like this, we generally use this type of word for our number of carbon atom. Then what will be the nomenclature for the particular functional group? Means we are having aldehyde, so what the suffix we generally use? So we generally use alk plus an, and that an will be used if there is a single bond, followed by the word al for aldehydes. Means if we are particularly talking about the nomenclature, that should be alkanal, and that alkanal means alk will tell you about the number of carbon atoms, an is telling you about the carbon-carbon single bond, and al is for CHO group, means aldehyde group is present in that case. So some examples are here. For example, this is, you know, your aldehyde is here. So bromine is also attached with this particular molecule. So what we will do, we will start our numbering from this carbonyl carbon, and then proceed second, third and fourth. Now we know that at third position there is a substituent, secondary substituent is attached. In that case, it should be used as a prefix. So the prefix is 3-bromo. 3 is the position and bromo is the prefix. So 3-bromo butanal. But for 4 carbon atom, an for single bond, and al for aldehydic functional group. And similarly, if we are having this particular molecule, in this case again we will have to do the numbering, and numbering will start from the carbonyl carbon and then proceeding to this particular methylene group, then this methylene group, and then this particular carbon which contain hydroxyl group. So it will be 4-hydroxypentanal. Similarly, this example is here, in which this particular carbon will be numbered 1, this will be second, at second position we are having phenyl group, so it will be 2-phenylethanol. So this is the pattern of nomenclature of different type of aldehydes. For example, here is you have different type of, for example, this is methanol, this is your ethanol, this is your propanol, this is your butanol, and this is, you know, 1, 2 and 3. So at second position we are having a methyl group, so it will be 2-methylpropanol. So this is nomenclature for the aliphatic aldehydes. Now we are coming to aromatic aldehydes. You know, aromatic compounds are the special category of the compounds in which there is sp2 hybridized carbon atom, there is presence of double bond, and the double bonds are delocalized over the ring, and it should contain diamagnetic ring current. It will follow the Hooker rules, or in case of non-magnetic aromatic system, it will follow the Krebs rule. So if it will satisfy all the conditions, the compound will be an aromatic compound, for example benzene. And to the benzene, when CHO group is attached, it will become aromatic aldehydes. So in case of aromatic aldehyde, generally we use the nomenclature as the derivative of the simplest aromatic aldehyde, and the simplest aromatic aldehyde is the benzaldehyde. So all other aromatic aldehyde will be having the nomenclature pattern as the derivatives of the benzaldehyde. For example, if we are particularly talking about this molecule, this is, you know, derivative of benzaldehyde, in which at third position we are having NO2 group. So it may be 3-nitro benzaldehyde. And if we are particularly talking about this particular compound, it is, you know, the common name is salicylaldehyde, and the IUPAC nomenclature will be at first position C double bond O group is here, and at second position hydroxyl group is here. So it will be 2-hydroxy benzaldehyde. So this is the case of aromatic aldehydes. Now we will come to some more aldehydes in which we are having, you know, cyclic system. If the CHO group is attached with a cyclic system, for example, this is a case in which it is attached with the cyclic system. For example, this one is a case of the aromatic compound, but still it can also be nomenclated as this particular category. So here the nomenclature will be cyclohexane carbaldehyde. It will have a different nomenclature, and it will be added as a prefix. So this particular ring, as we know that it is a cyclohexane ring, and to the cyclohexane ring we have attached CHO group, so the nomenclature will become cyclohexane carbaldehyde. And similarly, if we are particularly talking about this one, as we know, when the CHO group is removed from this particular ring, the ring will be naphthalene, and we know that in naphthalene we have first, second, third and fourth position. So the CHO group attached here is at second position, so the nomenclature will be 2-naphthalene carbaldehyde. Right, so 2-naphthalene carbaldehyde is the nomenclature. For example, we have different different type of the examples here. This is the ethanol, and this is, you know, different type of examples are here. For example, this is cyclohexane carbaldehyde. In this one we are having a double bond. Now we will have to mention the position of the double bond at which it is present. So the first position is given to the CHO group, and at second position double bond is here, so it will become, you know, because it contains 5 carbon atom into the ring, so it will be pent 2-ene. Now we will not use the word an, we will use the word en, and followed by the word al for functional group. And this one is, you know, now CHO group is here, and at second position we are also having the hydroxyl group, so it will be 2-hydroxy cyclopentane. Now we will have to give the number to the CHO group as well, because at second position the hydroxyl group is here, so it will be 2-hydroxy cyclopentane 1-carbaldehyde. It will be the nomenclature for the aldehyde. Now come to ketones. For ketones, first of all we will have the common system of nomenclature. And in case of common name, if we are particularly talking about ketones, it will be named after adding the word ketone to the name of the alkyl groups. For example, if we are having CH3CO CH3, at that time, as we know that we are having 2-methyl group, so the word should be dimethyl ketone, right? So this will be the common name for ketone. And if we are particularly talking about IUPAC nomenclature, then we will have to follow the rules for IUPAC nomenclature, and that rule will include the first selection of the longest carbon chain. After selection of the longest carbon chain, we will justify the position of the C double bond O group attached, and also justify the positions of different type of the substituents which are attached with that particular ketone, and then we will use the suffix. First of all, ALK will be used for number of carbon atom, AN will be used for single bond, EN will be used for double bond, YN will be used for triple bond, and for ketone we will use the word ONE as the suffix. So the name will be ALK ANONE LK norm. So it will be the nomenclature, IUPAC nomenclature for ketones. For example, this is the simplest ketone we have, and in this simplest ketone we are having CH3 group. So two methyl groups are here, it will be dimethyl ketone. And it's more commonly they are named as acetone. And if we are particularly talking about its IUPAC nomenclature, then we know that at second position the C double bond O group is here. So we will start the numbering from CH3 group. It will be given the number 1, and then 2 number will be given to the carbonyl group, so it will become 2 propanone. Then come to the second example is diphenyl ketone, commonly known as the benzophenone, and its name will be diphenyl methanone, because this one is the methanone and two substituents are attached, so diphenyl methanone. Now this one is methyl phenyl ketone, and more commonly it is known as acetophenone, and this is 1-phenyl-2-ethanone. Now this one is here isopropyl methyl ketone, if we are particularly talking about the common name of the system. And if we are talking about the IUPAC nomenclature at that time, we will now we can start the numbering from here 1, 2, and 3, and we can start the numbering here 1, 2, and 3 at second position. For example, we will start the numbering from here at second position. We are having our functional group, so we'll start it from here. So it will be at second position, and at three position we are having the methyl group, so it will be 3-methyl-2-one. Similarly, this is this is your vinyl group and this is your methyl group, so it will be methyl vinyl ketone. And the common and the IUPAC nomenclature for this one is but-3-ene-2-one, right? 1, 2, and 3. At second position we are having our functional group, and at third position we are having double bond. And for this one, for example, the nomenclature will be, this will be given the numbering at given the nomenclature as cyclopentyl ethyl ketone. And if we are talking about the IUPAC nomenclature of this particular compound, it will be at first position cyclopentyl group is here, 1-cyclopentyl-1-propanone, right? 1-cyclopentyl-1-propanone. And if we are talking about the this particular compound, this is a cyclic system, and this will be cyclobutanone. Now we have if in a molecule we have two groups, means one is ketonic group is also here, and CHO group means aldehydic group is here. At that time we have oxo and formyl as their nomenclature system, and we know that aldehyde group is given the priority than ketone. And if we are particularly talking about the carboxylic acid, and the priority of the carboxylic acid will be higher than the aldehyde. So for example, this is a case in which we are having the ketone group and we are having the aldehyde group. At that time higher priority will be given to the aldehyde, so numbering will start from aldehyde side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. At 3 position we are having methyl group, and at 5 position we are having our oxo group. Now, this will not be acting as a functional group. Instead, it will acting as a substituent. So, at fifth position, we are having oxo group. So, the nomenclature will be 3-methyl, 5-oxo, hexa, null. In this case, we know that it will be named as a derivative of the carboxylic acid. This is benzoic acid, and benzoic acid means carboxylic acid will always be at higher priority as comparison to aldehydic group. So the nomenclature in this case will be 2,4-methyl benzoic acid. So this is the pattern. For example, we are having different type of the nomenclature of different type of groups. We can have a look on these examples. For example, here we are having NH2 group, we are having ketonic group. Now we know that it contains many chains, so we will have to select the chain which is containing highest number of carbon atoms. So this is the chain that is containing highest number of carbon atom, and if I am talking about the numbering pattern, it will start from this one because our functional group is at lowest priority. So number one is given to this one, second, and at fourth position NH2 group will be here, and at third position we are having a substituent, we are having a group. So we are having two substituent, one is at third position and the second one is at fourth position. The nomenclature will be according to the alphabetical order. So it will be 4-amino, 3-isopropyl, because at third position we are having isopropyl group, 4-amino, 3-isopropyl, 2-hexanone, right? Because the longest carbon chain contains the 6 carbon atom and our functional group is ketone. Now this one is 2-pentynull. 2-pentynull is the nomenclature because one will be given to the CHO group and second at double bond. Right, similarly we have this particular compound, you can try yourself, and this will be, you know, selecting the highest carbon chain, and this will be selected from that side. This is your first, second and third. Now we can have our functional group as this is your functional group C double bond O, and hydroxyl group will act as the substituent, and this is your bond, that is triple bond is here. So the nomenclature will be 1,3-dihydroxy pent 4-yn, because at fourth position we are having triple bond 2-on, at second position we are having the ketonic group. Similarly, this is a case of diketone. Two C double bond O groups are there, two ketonic groups are there, and the numbering will start from here or from here, both are symmetrical, so we can start it from anywhere, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So at 2 and 4 position we are having a ketonic group, so it will be 2,4-pentanedione, right? This is, you know, cyclohexanone will be here, cyclohexanone, because it contains the double bond. And now we will have to identify the position. So the first position will be given to the ketonic group, and then second position will be given to this particular double bond, third, fourth and fifth. At fifth position we are having the hydroxyl group, so it will be 5-hydroxy-2-cyclohexanone, right? Similarly, we can have this one, and for this one we are having 3-thyl-2-hydroxy-cyclohexanone as the nomenclature. Here are the some examples in which we can write it. For example, this is for the first one, I am directly writing it. This is your 2-methyl-3-pentanone. Then for the second one is 3-methylpropanol, and for the C 2,6-octanedione, and for D we are having trans 2-methylcyclohexane carbaldehyde, and for E we are having 4-hexenol, and for F we are having this particular nomenclature. If we are having in any compound two different type of the functional group at that time, this is a general trend that which will be given the highest priority as comparison to another, and this is, you know, in the increasing order, so we can identify the type of functional group present in a molecule. And this case is only for the compounds containing more than one functional group, in which one will be given the priority as comparison to another one. So it is a general term, and we can identify it, and accordingly we can have the nomenclature pattern for that particular compound. Now we will come to the cyclic ketones. For cyclic ketones, we generally use, you know, the carbonyl carbon will always be given the first priority, and then the name can be given directly. For example, for this particular compound, or for this particular compound, this is the simplest, you know, because it's containing the cyclic system and it is containing the C double bond O group, so it will be cyclohexenone, because it contains the double bond. So at first position we are having double bond O, and at second position we are having the double bond. Now so the name will be 2-cyclohexenone, and for this one we are having at 3 position methyl group, so it will be 3-methylcyclopentanone, right? So this will be the nomenclature for the different kind of compounds. So this is all about the nomenclature pattern of aldehyde and ketones. In tomorrow's class, we will discuss about the physical properties and method of formation of aldehyde and ketones.